I retired in August of 2015 and opened the rescue in January of 2017, and we've been up and running ever since. I am Debbie Timmons. I am a retired police officer. I worked in law enforcement for 19 years, and once I retired, I decided to open a Siberian Husky rescue. We take in abused, neglected, or abandoned Siberian Huskies, or Huskies that for whatever reason have lost their home. Bring them in, give them a safe place to live, try to rehabilitate them, and get them adopted out to forever homes. My day usually starts, get up in the morning, I come out and feed everybody and change their water and then pick up their poop. And then I let them out and play with them. So after about an hour and a half of cleaning and feeding and watering, then I play musical dogs in the front yard and let everybody out to play. Unfortunately, everybody doesn't get along, so I have to let the groups that get along out to play together.
My name's Christina, and I volunteer with Debbie. I help her out as much as I can. We take the dogs to events and try to get the name out there. I help her with adoption applications, with home visits and things like that. And then I come to the actual place, to the rescue, and help her clean up and just hang out with the dogs. Socialize them as much as I can.
In the past couple years, I've seen a huge increase in the number of Siberian Huskies that have been surrendered to shelters. They're a challenging breed because they are smart. They're escape artists. Obviously, they're extremely difficult to contain, and they're a challenge to work with. So my goal is to bring them in here, keep them safe, educate the public on their specific needs, and then try to find appropriate homes for the ones that I have to make sure that the home that they go to is a safe forever home for them. A lot of people don't realize how much energy the Siberian Huskies have, and sometimes they'll take them home and they're like, oh my gosh, this dog is too energetic for me. So sometimes some people just adopt right out and everything goes great. Some people, if they're a little bit iffy, I'll let them do a foster to adopt program just to make sure that the dog is right for them. We have a website and a Facebook page, and we try to do a lot of events, adoption events at local pet stores and, you know, Dog Fest in Randleman. But we do as many adoption events as we can just to get our name out there, and we take our adoptable dogs to those events for people to meet. We take them to baseball games, football games. I take them everywhere that I can take them with a little Adopt Me vest on or Adopt Me collar on or leash that lets people know they're up for adoption.
Well, the biggest thing always, if you just want to say you're helping out, is money, of course, because, I mean, it's a lot of food. Vet visits, I mean, I'm sure Debbie's told you some that she's got a terminally ill one. I mean, heartworms out the butt. So, I mean, it's just crazy. So definitely money is a big way to stay involved. If you do have a little bit of time, Debbie's always open for people just coming to see the dogs, coming to hang out. All of them love people. So getting in touch with her is just the easiest way to do it, really.
I have been able to form a relationship with Project Challenge. Project Challenge is an organization that helps juveniles that have gotten in trouble and need to do community service. Those kids come out here and help a couple days a week, and they are very reliable. They're here when they're supposed to be. They work hard, they play with the dogs, they do a little bit of yard work. They come usually 3 days a week, and they'll spend anywhere from an hour and a half to 4 hours a day here, just doing whatever needs to be done on the property. And a couple of them have actually volunteered to help with some of the adoption events. So they have actually helped me tremendously over the past couple months. And then I have a few volunteers that are only available for adoption events. Unfortunately, everybody, you know, can't spend their whole day here like I can. They have to work a regular job. So I just take the help when I can get it. Our driving force, what we do is we take in abused, neglected, or otherwise unwanted Siberian Huskies. We take in some that have behavioral issues, some that are sick, and just give them, the ones that can't be adopted out, we give them a safe place to live the rest of their days.